Hi guys, my name is Andre, aka Mark Renton, and today I would like to talk about another deconstruction of a drum and bass classic called Renegade Terrorist. You might have heard it already. It was released in 1994, I think, on Moving Shadow. It's famous for its re-space, it's famous for its classic aim and break, it's famous for being a classic. So let's check what is in the track in there, okay? And maybe we start with easier things first and getting to the interesting one and of course also complicated ones afterwards. So let's start with the piano. And since it was released in 1994 and the piano sounds very familiar to the sound of the JD-990 from Roland or a JV-1080, but I was using my JD-990 because it was released earlier than a JV-1080. So let's listen to this, what I recorded here. Okay, what's happening here is that I think that's the AC1 or something, the first preset on the JD-990. And yes, I was equalizing the hell out of the track, so because the heights are quite high. And also here near some mids, so that the presence of the piano you actually can hear. Then there's some delay ongoing. I did this just with Ableton Live stuff. But yeah, that's it. Yes, the original sounds quite a little. I think they are also using MIDI echo on the long note. Yeah, so. But I like it as it is. So that was for the piano. And of course, listen to the drums. Let's head over to the drums of the drum and bass track. Okay, what do we have here? Obviously some aiming business. Let's remove the effects. Just what I did here. So, aiming slicing deluxe. That's the pattern, okay. But I think what's very essential here, back then I think they had a very cheap mixer or something and just distorting the head out of the machine. And what we do today with deluxe plugins like FabFilter Saturn. So what I am doing here is basically having a multi-band distortion. So I have the heights, the mids, and the lows, and the heights. I said distorting like hell. The mids, more or less the same. What about the low frequency? Just a little bit, okay. Yeah, so yeah, so they try to basically squeeze level out of the drum loop like hell. And since it's anyhow not high fidelity, I mean, you can do crazy things like that. I think it's quite famous, but I mean, wait, just remove this solo. So I think that's already coming quite close to the original, but because we can, we add multiple distortion. Maybe it's getting worse with that, but I like it. And just to add there some transient shaper so that we get again, not just this, you know, like the bar of drum loop. I added this transient shaper from X, what is it called? They do addictive drums as well. So listen to that. Just slightly, could be more. Now we've got on top the Think LC for the heights. Okay, so that's the drums. Let's go to the bass. So basically the bass Respace, I think most of you guys are familiar with that, but the Respace basically is that. Okay, so there is not a way how to do the correct Respace. That's my version, listen to that. Okay, and what's happening here is basically what these guys did back then. Imagine saw waveform from the synthesizer and then just detune it. Okay, that's basically what we do with all the machines here. So you get a rich fat sound and with phase cancellation and detuned stuff and moving things around. But I think what was special back then, here and there, I think 2 to 3 times or so, they resampled the whole thing through their arcade samplers or even maybe something more cheap or so. And yeah, so these days I was using Serum just to basically do the more or less same thing. And my Serum is not so important what it's actually doing, but... Yeah, so just some detuned saw waves, and then on top we've got, of course, some equalizing because, you know, like I like to layer it with a sub synthesizer, sub bass. Okay, then what else do we've got here? Some compressor, nothing special, just adding some mojo, you know. And spectrum just for me to see if everything is fine. And if we combine these things, we've got a fat bass. Okay, that's the Respace. You know, like today, like in 2020, there are way more sophisticated Respaces out there, especially with synthesizers like Serum and this wavetable thing from Ableton Live. And if you combine everything, you know, it's like blowing mind. So you can do so many way more complex things than back then these guys did. But we, you know, we try to recreate the song. But there's something else ongoing. And there's a sample from, what is this track called? Let me check. Smith and Mighty Anyone in the Mellow Mix. Listen to that. Okay, if we do everything together, maybe you get the idea. Okay, so that sample is also going on there, and you heard already the vocal. And I think that's a nice way to head over to the vocal slash sample section. So you heard it already. Listen to that, just the whole song again. And another sample is this one here. And very often we've got in the track this one. Sometimes also alone here in the beginning. And that's called the Ja Shaka. You find it on YouTube, okay? Ja Shaka. However, you know, like in the original track, there's still some samples undiscovered. I got most information from who sampled and just recreated it. It was more or less very easy. And what took me the longest was here this 0G Datafire sample. So funny because it's the same sample. It's actually the same sample I was looking for Wipeout remix I'm working on parallel, which sounds like this. Okay, and if we just cut it, you get the Renegade sample. Amazing. This was the last piece missing for me in this track. I hope you enjoyed it, and so maybe after this YouTube video I do some additional stuff and things and want to upload it on SoundCloud. I hope you like my recreation, my deconstruction, reconstruction, whatever, remix. And yeah, please give me a like, give me a thumb up, give me a comment, and talk to you soon. Bye.